Okay, so welcome to the Europlacer booth here at IPC Apex Expo. I'm joined by Mark Argeris, who is responsible for the printer side of the business here. So Europlacer has been known obviously for many years as a pick and place and manufacturer of high-end printers. This is the latest platform we've got here, the iiP7, or is it the
EP7,
you yep. call it. Okay. Tell us a little bit about some of the key features that are involved in this machine.
Sure. My name's Matt Argeris. I'm our senior applications engineer with Europlacer, and this is our current generation Europlacer EP7 screen printer.
Okay. Excellent. So tell me some of the key features that are involved in this new printer.
Absolutely. There's certainly a lot to talk about. Some of my favorite features include our unique look down camera vision system.
Okay.
And so, of course, we have a lower camera that looks at the PCB and circuit board, but we also have a camera on top of the stencil that allows us to know where the PCB is at during print height. And
right.
So this unique feature and dual roving camera allows us to get very, very accurate and repeatable prints time after time.
Right. So let's just drill down into that for a little bit.
I mean, sure.
First of all, when it comes in, when the board comes in, it looks at the four fiducials and measures from that point and then moves up to the top camera and you measure the four fiducials again. So in actual fact, it's measuring each board each time, where other systems are really setting it up and trying to run a batch of boards.
Yeah, exactly. Mm. So as a standard process, the PCB will come in and our lower camera, we can use as many alignment points or apertures as we want to.
Right.
So in this case, you say four of them, and we'll look at it with the lower camera, move it around a little bit, mm-hmm. and understand how it moves mechanically in the machine. Mm-hmm. And then we perform this quick 30-second calibration where the stencil is out and we bring the PCB all the way up to print height.
Yep.
And you can imagine that during that motion, there's a lot that can happen, mm-hmm. especially when we're trying to align to microns.
Right.
And so having that upper camera allows us to say, hey, this is where the PCB should be, and this is where it's really at.
Mm-hmm.
And we can quickly create that scaling model that we can apply to all of the panels and get us that consistent alignment.
Great.
So,
yeah. Okay, super. So, looking at other features in the machine, first of all, what's the maximum board size it'll accept?
We can run 24 inches by 20 inches or 6'10 by 5'15 millimeters.
Okay.
We can accommodate stencil sizes down from 23 inches up to 29 by 29.
Okay.
And of course, anything in between.
Okay. Okay. And of course, the key question is, what about the cycle time on it?
Cycle time, I'm glad you asked. Mm-hmm. Standard 9 seconds, mm-hmm. and then we have options to upgrade to 7 and up to 5.
Wow.
So we are a very, very fast machine.
Yeah.
And so.
Yeah. Well, if you can get it to 5, that's equivalent to the fastest in the industry, really.
Yeah. Yep.
Very
yeah,
fast.
I can assure you that this will not be the gate in your process line.
Yeah, absolutely. So one of the things you've always had in your machines, your printers, is the ability to also add paste or glue top up after the stencil print.
Yep.
You still got that built in there, so that essentially comes in after the printing process has been done and tops up.
You're exactly right. It's a very intelligent system. Mm-hmm. We can put down glue, paste, epoxy. People have used flux, so the uses for it are very wide, and our customers are always coming up with new use cases, mm-hmm. which is nice to see. And so we have a height check that'll be performed before there's any paste on the circuit board, and then after the print process, we can go down and put down any of the deposition that we need.
Right.
And
right.
so, yep.
Right.
Very.
Now,
very
another
easy.
Another unique aspect of this machine, as I understand it, is it also dispenses a barcode label at the end of the process.
Yes, it does. Yep.
So that you can uniquely identify each board.
You're right. We can put down as many barcode labels as we want in production,
mm-hmm.
and we would do that after the print to ensure that there's no print gap between your stencil and your PCB,
mm-hmm.
and it will also scan it, verify it was placed, and tie it to any traceability features that we have. So say you want to view the paste inspection or your bridging and 2D results later on, all that would be tied to those serial numbers.
Right, okay. So let's look at some of the other features it's got. I mean, first of all, we've got a barcode scanner here, which presumably is used for identifying each board and each stencil at every part
of this process. One of the new features of our software, of course, you have the ability to validate on stencils or squeegees or paste types and to make sure the operator is running with the correct components. Yeah. But you also have the ability to go further and validate anything that you as the owner may want to keep track of. So say you have a specific process carrier that is set up with this job, or you have specific tooling fixtures that are with this job.
Okay.
So we can program that and use that as traceability too. And so, yep, that scanner would be used for it and to log those.
Great, great. And then finally, I want to just look at the software here, because it's a huge display we've got here.
Yeah.
And this is the latest GUI interface, is it?
You're right. This is, I like to say, just like our cell phones are, it mimics it. If you know how to use iOS or Android, you'll already be familiar with our software. So everything is pinched to zoom and you can drag box around it nice and easy. Very, very intuitive.
So one other thing I wanted to ask you about, Mark, is the understencil cleaner. I believe you've updated this system as well. Can you tell us about that?
Yeah, I'd love to. So we had talked about earlier how we have a cycle time of 5 seconds, and we were able to develop an underscreen cleaner to match.
Okay.
And so this is a single pass underscreen cleaner. Mm-hmm. And what that means is that the leading edge, as it goes from the front to the rear of the stencil, will have your solvent on it. And at the same time, the trailing edge will have the vacuum turned on.
Okay.
And so now, in one pass, we're doing a wet and dry stroke, which is really able to keep this machine pumping out the panels at the
right
rate.
Right, that keeps up with your production rate.
Yeah. Absolutely. In addition to that, we offer a quick change cassette. So it's two hands, and you can quickly lift it up and out and drop your new one on.
Right.
So there's very, very little operator interaction to keep this machine running.
Quick changeover. That's
exactly
that's
right.
That's very important.
It is.
Great.
Sweet. Thank you.
Okay. So, Matt, thank you very much for giving us a run through on the new machine here. We're going to take a walk over now to the other side of the booth to have a look at the latest pick and place system. So now we're on the other side of the Europlacer booth, and I'm joined by Chris Merrill. Nice to see you, Chris.
Thanks for coming by, Trevor. I know you're a busy guy.
Yeah, I know. So we're standing in front of the iiN2, which is basically the next level on the inneo series of machines. So tell us what's different in this system.
Well, the inneo's been around for a while. It's had a few iterations, a few upgrades. This is the next generation. So we've invented our own new conveyor. It's got sensors all the way down the length of the machine.
Okay.
So it does a much better job with odd-shaped boards and cutout boards. Mm-hmm. So it knows where the board is at all times, and it automatically optimizes. It stops in the best location where the highest density of picks and placement goes on. So it helps pick up the speed a little bit as well.
So the heads are going to have the least amount of travel.
Correct, and the least amount of derate.
Right. Okay, so it's great. It's got that amount of monitoring in there. So what other features are built into the system?
So we've done a significant upgrade on the camera system. So now the camera is capable of much finer pitch on micro BGAs and down to 03105s.
Right, okay. Wow, so it's going right down to the very smallest devices that you can
get. And we have a new feeder that feeds that component, a 4 millimeter pitch feeder.
Okay. And what about the placement speed? Any upgrades on that? Or?
Nope, still the same placement speed. We did not change any of that. Okay. This machine is not about the horsepower. It's much more about the accuracy, productivity, all the tools that are built into this, the fast-loading, inexpensive feeders that allow you to do changeover so much quicker and replenishment so much quicker, even on the fly. So the productivity is really what this machine's about.
Right, okay. So let's have a look at the feeder. Is this a new feeder that you brought out for this machine? Or is this?
No, sir.
This is the one that's upgradable from
our Gen 3 e-feed feeders.
Okay. So it certainly looks a smaller feeder. There's not less capability for it to get snagged up, for sure.
Now this can go down to 01005 at world-class pick rates.
Yeah, okay. It's an intelligent feeder, obviously.
Yes, sir.
So you can literally place it anywhere on the feeder bank.
Yeah, you marry the barcode to a to the reel, and you put it anywhere on the machine and just go.
Just go, okay, right.
And, you know, we're carried along here. We've kind of got a new generation of touchscreen. We've got a Windows 11 touchscreen, really easy to use. I think one of the themes that we're seeing is the lack of availability of skilled labor.
Right.
So we're having customers tell us that they're hiring people from a sub shop down the street. They're bringing them in and they're teaching them to run our machines. And and I think that's going to be really important going forward here is, you know, everybody's a lot more robots, a lot more automation. You also need people somewhere on the floor and they're not always the, you know, the most trained.
So So it's going to be easy for them.
Have to make it easy. If they can run Windows and do a drop-down menu, they can remember how to do this and how to do that.
Right, right. Excellent. Okay. Well, certainly looks an impressive piece of equipment. Is the footprint still the same size as the
old one? Yes, it is.
Yeah.
Still double-sided, 264 8-millimeter feeders.
Yep.
Using the entire workspace. It's not changed in any regard there. We do have enhanced electrical verification, and we can now put a voltmeter on this, so we can do Schottky diodes and Zener diodes. That is a differentiator as well for us.
Right, right, okay. Wow, so it measures the electrical capacity of these
Yes, the caps
devices.
And resistors, any of your passive components.
Okay, excellent. Good. Okay, so that's the iiN2 there from Europlacer. Chris, thank you for showing it to us today.
Yes, sir.
All right.